Hey everyone, welcome back. So I am going to be growing cucumbers this year inside, hydroponically. These are the Beit alpha cucumbers. These are parthenocopic, so they do not need pollination, so they're good for inside. So I'm just going to get my seed started. I'll show you how I do that. So I take a rockwool cube. I'm going to actually put two seeds. So I just make two holes. I don't use the one in the center just because I want it to be easier to separate later. So I make my two holes just like that. So there's technically three holes now, but I'm only going to use the two outside. This is just tap water. I just filled it from the tap down here in the basement sink. I'm just going to let it soak and fill up with water. I get my two seeds. I'm only going to grow one plant, but I'll do two seeds. So I got my two seeds there. I'm going to take my lid. I just put this on there because that's full of water now. Just take my seeds, drop them in the holes. Just push them down a little bit. I usually don't push them too far in, so hopefully maybe you can see that. And they're just below the surface. And I just kind of close it up a little bit. Doesn't really matter that much. I'm going to empty out my water. I don't need that water anymore. This will go in here. The lid will go on it, and I'll put it under my grow lights. So this is where it's going to go. I have my two grow lights, and I believe I just turned them off here. Yep. So I will put them there. I put the grow lights kind of close so it helps keep it warm. And this keeps the condensation in, and they will sit there till they germinate. Then I will set this area up over here underneath my hidden harvest grow lights and my other grow light, and that's where they will ride out their winter. Hey everyone, so it's time to get the indoor garden working. I'm going to get the cucumbers going. I have these. I planted these seeds a while ago. This is actually starving for some nutrients now because it's in a very weak nutrient solution. So you can see it's looks like it's got some nutrient deficiencies there. But I am going to get this planted. There's 20 gallons of water in here. I filled that yesterday to let it sit overnight to purge any chlorine or anything like that. So I am going to mix 1 teaspoon per gallon. So that's going to be 20 teaspoons, which is going to be about 96 grams of master blend, calcium nitrate, and then 10 teaspoons of the epsom salt. So this is 10 teaspoons right here. I just wanted to get a weight on it, so I did 10 teaspoons and weighed it, was 48 grams. And then I will add the other 10. Okay, we're going to add 20 teaspoons of the calcium nitrate. That was 10. And again, I did that so I could weigh it. And that came out to 63.4 grams is 10 teaspoons. So I'll add the other 10. Okay, then I'm going to add the 10 teaspoons of Epsom salt. And again, I just did it in here to weigh it, and that came out to 54.3 grams, just in case anybody's interested. And then I will now stir it all up. Then I will start to check my pH. Okay, so I added all the nutrients. And now we're going to check the pH. Right now it's about 6.06. So if you're a cucumber, check my super secret sheet here, which is so I need it 5.5 to 6.0, so I have to bring it down a little bit. And this is just lemon juice you buy at the store. And then I'll mix that up. Okay. Check it again. About 5.87. So 5.5 to 6.0, 5.87 is below the 6. So I'm going to call that good. Okay, and then as far as PPMs are, we're looking for 1190 to 1750. We're about 1315 right now. And the PPMs of the water was 137. So we're sitting at about 1180 right now, PPMs. So I think that's fine. It calls for 1190 to 1750. So I'm going to call that good. I think we're going to plant them. Okay, taking it out now. Let me show you the root system I got on there. It was growing in there for a little bit longer than it needed. So I would normally have put more water in the tote, but since I have such a large root structure, I left the water down a bit. And we are just going to plant them in there. Try to get all the roots in there. Not damaging too much. The camera's been giving me fits here, so. So I got that in there. I just checked, make sure the roots are hanging in the water plenty. And we will now start cycling the lights for 12 hours on, 12 hours off. My timer's already set. I'm only going to use the one light for right now. So just to let you know, this is a Beit alpha cucumber. It's parthenocopic, so it doesn't need pollination, which is why I chose it to grow indoors. So this will sit here, cycle on, 12 hours off, 12 hours on with the light, and that'll do it. I'll do some updates as we go along. All right, if you guys liked the video, click that like button. Please subscribe and leave a comment. Okay?